I started this recording already, and somehow, some way, I managed to override it, like, while I was on the phone. I don't understand how that was even possible, but I guess that's a new feature for if I want to edit audio clips while they're still here. But that kind of screwed me over, because I got distracted after that, and now I'm doing this at fucking 2 in the morning. 2 in the goddamn morning, and I should be asleep. This video is going to be 10 goals for 2022. Very stereotypical, but it actually took me quite a while to come up with this list, because I wasn't thinking properly, I guess. I don't know. But it's just 10 things I want to do. Some things are way more difficult than others. I'm gonna just go down the list and we'll see where it goes. So first up on the list is 52 videos. I don't think that I did that this year, even if I'm counting the shorts, which I'm not, because they're usually just re-uploaded things for just so I can keep them. I still want to get 52 videos up on my channel by the end of the year. Though I didn't do that this year, or last year. Last year, that's kind of funny. I got kind of close to it, considering everything, considering what I was actually expecting. I got closer than I expected, which, you know, that's okay. But 52 videos, you know, if it's right, then that would mean, I think, once every week. One video every week. And that's very much possible. I just need to like stay with it. That's like the max I could do right now. The next one on the list is getting physically fit. Just like in my other video, I still want to continue that. And I actually did start that July of last year. And the fact that I stuck with it is impressive to me. I wasn't doing nearly enough during the beginning, but worked my way up towards a normal workout routine. And for the past, like, I think several months now, I've had a pretty solid workout routine. I still need to upgrade it and everything. It's 30 minutes and it's all just calisthenics. It works and I am seeing results, which is making me very, very happy. Like, it's so slight, but it's like, you know what? This is exactly what I wanted. That's like everything to me right now, because it's like the number one thing would be like that is supposed to help like with self-image and like, I don't know. I just want that physique. I want to look better than I do, mainly for myself, but you know, same reason why anyone else would do it. And then the second reason, which is originally why I started, I kept hearing people say that, oh, this is how they helped with their depression, and I'm like, okay, well, that sounds like a very healthy alternative than picking up a bad habit or something, you know what I mean? I'd rather exercise first and experiment with that, see if it makes me happy, rather than immediately throw my life down the drain. Yeah. Next on the list, license. There's two licenses I need to get. One is a motorcycle license, which I feel like is going to be way easier to get than my actual driver's. I'm 90% sure all I have to do is go down there and actually take the tests, but my dad is nice enough to let me, like, he's talking about taking me to an actual course. And though I don't think I need it because I've been driving for a while, I feel like it would be good to do that. So maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll just go take the test. It depends, but either way, I want to get my license this year. Very much possible. I was supposed to do it last year and probably years before that. I just haven't. Next on the list, improve mental health. I don't know how I'm going to do that, but that is definitely a good goal, because the way I think is just solidly screwed. the only reason I think I have like hope for myself is because I have moments of like, okay, there were 2 days specifically where I just felt happy, like not overly joyed, not like crazy, just, you know, I felt good. And I was like, whoa, okay, this must be what like everybody else feels every day, or almost every day. Just, I felt alive those 2 days. I don't understand why, and I still don't understand why, but I talked about it. And it was great. The fact that that happened, and the fact that it is attainable in some regard, means that if I can either get therapy or just start reading a whole bunch of like philosophy stuff and like learning how to control the way my mind works, which I think is very possible, then I can just improve my mental health in that way. Next on the list. Okay. Getting my physical health under better control. Mainly, like, firstly, the reason why I wrote it down in the first place was because I want to diet, because I have had this phrase stuck in my head for some reason, and I don't know why, but it's, I am become trash compactor. I've just had that in my head for the past like 3 weeks, and it's mostly because I've been eating like absolute garbage, I think. If I can eat properly, what foods are good for me, what foods are not, then that'll help me a lot. I need to learn how to cook also, but I don't know. Dieting is what I meant with that, and then what was the second thing? Well, second thing is literally getting my health under control, because like I have certain things, like for example, there's like consistent pains in certain areas that I'm like, I don't know if that's normal. And I saw, I think, a video on Instagram that was like, the normal amount of pain is zero. And I was like, oh, is that true? Because I'm always in pain, so. Anyway, as long as I can figure out something, then I'll have accomplished that goal. Okay, the next one is scary as fuck to me. It's applying to some sort of college, online or otherwise. Online would be me kind of taking the easy way out, because I've always said that I'd really rather not do online, because that usually makes for a lesser learning experience. Like if I'm there physically, I'm most likely going to learn the subject if I'm interested in it. The problem is I don't know what I'm interested in, so I have to figure that out. My next goal: get a job or become fully involved with an online business or anything that creates stable income. Yeah, I need money. That one's kind of simple, but it's like also a little bit scary to me. It's less scary than college to me though. Also, they're a little bit interchangeable with each other, which is why they're right next to each other, but also because I just thought of them at the same time. It's like if I get one, then it's okay if I don't get the other, if that makes sense. I'd rather have both, like all of them though. Okay, my next one is like probably not gonna happen, but I'd love it if it did happen. My next one is move out. The likelihood of that happening is very slim unless I become like super wealthy, because I, you know, I don't really feel like I have to move out. I'm just getting driven crazy as anyone else would. But you know, I have to do that eventually, and this year would be great. So I put it on here and I'm like, you know what? Maybe if I write it down, I can do things to help make that happen. Next one. I don't know why I put this here. It's probably because I was running out of ideas, which is fix my sleep schedule. And that won't be very difficult. Like it never is. The only thing about it is like, I don't want to be kept up by other people. That's the only thing I ever struggle with. Cause like if I can fall asleep by 8, someone's going to come in at like 9 or 10. I don't know. But my final one is make music. And I've kind of been doing that, but like not in the way that I want to, because I don't have music production software. Like I said before in one of my other videos, I bought it and it basically scammed the hell out of me. I don't think it was intentional on their end, but it didn't work at all. And I got no refund, and it was like $300, like close to it. I don't know. Once I get music production software, I'm gonna be golden. Cause I was afraid of my video editing software for a little bit when I first got it, but once I like started actually editing videos, it started coming to me. I'm like, you know what? This is really easy once you just look at everything and read everything. It's like not that hard. It just takes practice. So I'm thinking that it's going to be the exact same thing with my music production. And I also think that I want to get FL Studio because it's not as professional as some of the other ones that I'm forgetting the names of. It's what a lot of the people that I used to listen to made their music on. It's like, I can put myself in their shoes in my head. Like I can totally see myself doing what they did. So it's like, if I get maybe the same stuff that they had, then I will have the same likelihood. It's kind of an odd mentality, and I'm describing it poorly, but the only reason I'm talking about this is like, I just want to do it. And like, that is a goal, so yeah. I believe that was 10. There you have it, 10 goals for 2022. I'm gonna really try to hold myself accountable and get at least 8 of them done. I'm already not holding myself accountable by saying that. I should get 10 of them done, but there's a likelihood that 2 of them are not gonna get done. I hope it does though. Anyway, Happy New Year's. See y'all.